Hey everyone, thanks for tuning into CryptoZX. I really appreciate you stopping by my channel today. To all my viewers watching my video right now, can I please ask you guys to smash that like button and hit the red subscribe button if you haven't already. This does help with the channel tremendously and it also keeps me motivated on making videos for you guys. But with that being said, let's jump right into today's content. Alright guys, before I begin, I would like to say the disclaimer. Anything on this channel should not be taken as financial advice because I am not a financial advisor. Cryptocurrencies are super volatile, so please do your own due diligence and research before investing in these markets. Looking at the overall crypto market cap today, guys, you guys can see we are currently sitting at $2.78 trillion. We are up 2% in the last 24 hours. Meanwhile, BTC dominance is currently sitting at 39.5%. Looking at the overall markets, guys, we are starting to see the markets rebound once again. Obviously, in the last 1 hour, you are seeing some red across the board, but overall, the markets have really rebounded over the past 24 hours. Nice way to start this reversal. I have been talking about this for quite a while on my channel, especially for the last 48 hours, saying that, you know, this correction is very much needed because we have been seeing continuous growth since the start of this bull cycle, and especially during Q4. Q4 has been extremely bullish. If you are a regular viewer on my channel, especially if you have been following me for the throughout the years, I have been talking about, you know, the Q4 term specifically, and Q4 does tend to be the most bullish time for the crypto space, and especially in a bull cycle. So we need to keep that in mind because nothing is going to go up straight forever. Obviously going to see consolidation phases coming here and there before we do see continuous rise. So in these times, you do not want to get shaken out during the week, you know, when whales try to manipulate the markets, because their main goal is to shake out the weekends, and you do not want to be the weekends. But today, guys, I want to talk about none other than one coin that I have never covered on this channel, but has been on my radar for quite a while and has been requested on my channel for a very, very long time. And that's none other than Avalanche. All right, so Avalanche community, welcome to the CryptoZX channel. If you have not already subscribed, what are you waiting for? Subscribe that button, and we are about to take this CryptoZX channel literally to the moon. CryptoZX community is very strong, so come join the team. So now if we are looking at Avalanche's price right now, you guys can see we are currently trading at $115.83. Avalanche is down 8% in the last 24 hours in USD comparative. It's also down 8.4% in Bitcoin comparative over the last 24 hours. Market cap right now is $25.9 billion, and the 24-hour trading volume is at $1.7 billion. Avalanche current rank on CoinMarketCap and on CoinGecko is at the top 11 spot, guys. It has yet to enter the top 10. It's right below Dogecoin, but we could possibly see that reversal happen very, very soon. Zooming out and looking at the bigger picture for Avalanche, guys, has been going absolutely insane in just the last year alone. Avalanche is up 2,764%, and in just the last 30 days, it's up 67.7%. So let's not forget that when we are looking at the prices of Avalanche. But now let's get into the technical analysis. Well, we're all here for the exciting stuff. Where is Avalanche going and where could we be going in the immediate short term? So let's check that out, shall we? So as you guys can see, Avalanche has had a beautiful, beautiful spike over this course of 1 year. And, you know, if we are just going back to August itself, guys, you cannot make this up. Let's say August 1st, for instance, Avalanche was trading at 15.31 cents. So if you managed to pick up some Avalanche around there, and you know, you actually held throughout to this point and actually did not sell any, you would be up, as of recording this video, you would be up 800%, guys. Where could you see these kind of gains being made outside the crypto space? This is why crypto is the future. Crypto is the money-making area, but again, you need to know how to win this market. Obviously, you know, we have a lot of newcomers coming in the markets. This might, you know, I have a lot of new viewers on my channel that are, you know, very, very new to crypto. If you are viewing this and you are very, very new to crypto, if this is your first year for crypto, you need to keep one thing in mind, guys. And this is coming from someone that has been in the crypto space for quite a while. You know, we all want to see instant gains, you know. We all want to see Lambos tomorrow. We all want to see us, like, you know, just doing crazy good next day. But that's not how it works, guys. You know, patience is very much needed. We need to do our own due diligence and research and pick the coins that are going to shape the cryptocurrency space's future. And if you have done these due diligence and research and have done your research and have invested what you can afford to lose, then holding and patience is your number one key to follow, guys, because, you know, we're obviously going to see nice spikes, and we're also going to see some crazy, crazy sea of red across the board. Because again, markets are very much, you know, especially the cryptocurrency markets, are unregulated. So there are big whale players that have big amounts of money that can, you know, manipulate the markets to shake out the weekends, and you do not want to get shaken out. So the moral of the story is, look at the people that bought around here and that actually held. They are up 800%. But there's obviously times, you know, when we saw drops happen within Avalanche's price along with other altcoins, people lose faith. People just want instant gains. That's not how it works, guys. Patience is very much needed in this market. But yeah, like 800% in just a couple months, guys, it's absolutely insane. But right now, as you guys can see, Avalanche had, hit an all-time high just a couple days back at 147.9 cents, guys. And since then, we are seeing a correction occur for Avalanche of about, if we are measuring that, 21.79%. Very normal. Now, this might be shocking some people, especially the newcomers. Why is Avalanche price not skyrocketing? Why are we not going to $200? Why are we not going to $500? Then, etc. But one thing you guys need to keep in mind, you know, Avalanche is up just from the beginning of this November, guys. Avalanche is up, you know, it has a spike all the way to all-time highs of 74.8%. And even after that drop, we're still up 35%. And even the course of, you know, the last couple months, it's up 650%. So let's not forget that when we are looking at the charts, guys. You cannot just look at the smaller time frames and judge, a coin from that. Because like I mentioned, nothing is going to skyrocket straight up to the sky. That's absolutely not the case. If you thought that, I will be the one who will come out to tell you guys that's definitely not the case. We are going to see some consolidation phases coming here and there. And, that's just how the markets really work. But one thing that's interesting about Avalanche is that now you may be asking yourself or asking hey, CryptoZX, why is Avalanche, you know, going absolutely insane? What's really causing Avalanche to be trending everywhere? And why is there so much momentum behind its side? I'll share as to why that is. So Avalanche is once again another coin that it's its own blockchain. And if you guys don't know, you know, coins with their own blockchain, such as Solana, Avalanche, Polkadot, list goes on and on, Cardano. These are the projects that have been absolutely killing it this year. And they have been skyrocketing, and we're seeing so much demand coming in from retail side, developer side, institution side. And that is because of one factor and one reason, and that is Ethereum. All these are somewhat, you know, quote unquote, called Ethereum killers. And they are putting major, major pressure on Ethereum, because if you guys don't know, Ethereum has massive, massive scalability issues going on right now. And we've been hearing ETH 2.0 and how it's going to solve that. I don't see that happening, because I believe Ethereum is old tech now. Yes, it's going nowhere. It is going to be seen as a store of value now. But these coins such as Avalanche, Solana, Cardano, you know, these are the coins that are trying to compete with one another to see which one really is going to take over Ethereum. Right now, the top two contenders are Solana and Cardano, without a doubt. They're putting major, major pressure on Ethereum, but Avalanche has entered that conversation as well. And if they continue what they're doing, guys, this could possibly be over where Solana and Cardano are. So that could get very, very exciting to see a battle between these three to really see which one is going to take over that spot over the next coming year or so. But yeah, guys, looking at, you know, Avalanche's price right now, Avalanche has been seeing a beautiful, beautiful, crazy rally towards the upside. You know, this does not, scare me at all. If you guys don't know, if you're a regular viewer on my channel, I do tend to take the 23.65 notch retracement level with, you know, it's extremely bullish because this zone, 23.6, I play it as an all-time high territory. As soon as we see more volume kick in, we're off to the races. And we need to keep one other factor in mind. That is the king of the markets, which is Bitcoin. Overall, Bitcoin has finally seen more momentum gaining for itself over the past couple hours. We did see Bitcoin go all the way up to $59,416. And if you guys know, if you guys are a regular viewer on my channel, I want Bitcoin to go above 6250, and you know, actually go above here, and that's where I will be getting happy. Until then, we're still on the shaky end of the spectrum. But as you guys can see, we did try to break out of this. We got rejected. But this time around, let's see if we are able to break out of here. If we are, great, things are going to look very, very nice for the space. And we do not want to be ignoring the Bitcoin price, because Bitcoin, at the end of the day, is the leading indicator of the cryptocurrency markets. Everything is correlated with Bitcoin. But right now, what we're seeing with Avalanche, Solana, is that they are kind of decoupled from Bitcoin over the past month, 2 or 3 months, and have not been really impacted much by Bitcoin movements. Yes, if Bitcoin drops, we are seeing them obviously getting being affected by it, but it's not affecting them, you know, very, very greatly. It's a small retracement and boom, you know, we see a recovery and new all-time high a week from now. And so, you know, you guys get the picture, and that really shows how much momentum really is building up in these new Ethereum killers. And we will see what happens in the upcoming, you know, year or so. But I still do believe, guys, that AVAX has more time to go up, as you know, we're not even done this Q4 yet. And I do believe as we go into December, AVAX is going to rip out of this zone and start seeing newer all-time highs. And my next price target would be that $200 mark. That would be very, very exciting for the AVAX community. But if we are looking at the BTC dominance, guys, BTC dominance index has been declining over the past couple days. This is something that should not be ignored as well, because Bitcoin dominance basically means that the amount of money percentage, how much percentage is in Bitcoin and how much money of the overall market is in altcoins. Right now, 42.17% of the money, 2.8 trillion, 42.17% of that is in Bitcoin right now. And as this number, you know, declines and Bitcoin stays where it is, that basically means that money is flowing out of Bitcoin back into the cryptocurrency markets, which whereas altcoins are going to start seeing, you know, rallies occur within their prices. And we're already starting to see a trickle effect of that happening as we speak. So we need to keep that in mind. But as I have mentioned in my other videos, if you are a regular viewer on my channel, I have said this, you know, BTC dominance can skyrocket any second, because Bitcoin still has a lot of momentum on its side. And especially if it goes above 60 to 50, we're off to the races, guys. So we need to keep these factors in mind. And also, if you guys don't know, AVAX is also a proof of stake consensus. Very, very interesting, guys. And this is something that you do not want to be ignoring as of now. 61.4% of the AVAX circulation supply is being staked right now. And this should not be ignored at all. This basically means that 61.4% of the circulation supply cannot be purchased right now for regular users. So only roughly about 40%, 39% of the supply is on the centralized exchanges to be purchased. And this really does create, you know, a supply shock and basic economic rule, supply and demand. When there's massive demand, which we are seeing happen in Avalanche, and there's lower supply to be purchased, guess what happens to the price? Skyrockets. And that's exactly what we're seeing right now. And if you are in it for the long haul, guys, let's say you do see Avalanche, you have done your due diligence and research, you believe Avalanche is the future, and you don't really care about the short-term gains here and there, then, you know, staking would be the best strategy to go for. But as of now, guys, Avalanche is holding very, very nicely. We could revisit this level of resistance at this 110.65 cents mark if Bitcoin decides to have a rejection. But if not, I do see in the next coming days, you know, we really start gaining traction once again and start heading towards newer all-time highs, because we're still in the all-time high territories. But with that being said, guys, this is it for today's update. Let me know in the comment section below, what are you guys doing right now and where you could see Avalanche price go at the end of this year. I would love to know your thoughts down below. And also, guys, If I can ask you guys for one favor, that is if you can like, subscribe, and comment. That's literally all I ask for, and that would mean the world to me. I love you all. You guys have been killing it with the support from the bottom of my heart. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I'll continue delivering these videos for you guys, and I just know we're about to go to the moon. Crypto ZX to 100,000, and I know we will get there. I love you all once again. You know, stay safe out there. Safety, health, and family comes first, and everything else absolutely comes later. I will see you guys tomorrow. It's been Crypto ZX, and peace out.